guys, welcome and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And if this is the first time that you're watching my video, then I welcome you. And if you're already a subscriber, then I thank you for watching my videos and for subscribing to my YouTube channel. And as you've already read from the title, in today's video, I would be sharing my interview experience with IIM Rohtak. So, as some of you might be aware that I am currently a student at IIM Rohtak who is pursuing a PGDM course and I have completed two of my semesters. So guys, let's just now dwell into the questions and how it was. So for IIM Rohtak, as of now, what I remember is I think there were two or three panelists that were there. And both of them were male and maybe in their mid 30s to mid 40s, that is what. And it was a pretty good interview. I had answered all of the questions and it really went well. It was very comfortable in my zone. That was there. And one extra thing for IIM Rohtak was it was having an extempore as well before the main interview. So just in case if you're not sure how to prepare for the extempore, so I think they had given me a minute or two. I don't remember now at this moment very clearly, but a minute or two was given for me to just gather all my ideas and just make a basic outline in my head so that I can put forward what I had to say for 30 seconds to a minute. So that is what the time was given. Just in case if you're not sure how you can prepare for it, then my recommendation would be that just in case if you are not a person who can have all the ideas muggled up in your brain, then I would rather suggest you to just make a note of it. So when you're thinking, just write down kind of the power words or just the words that you wish to have in that particular sentence. Like All you need to is just say is a paragraph, okay? And in the paragraph, you can just divide into sentences wherein with a flow of sentence, like an intro sentence, maybe the middle part sentence wherein you are having the arguments that you need to present, and maybe coming to an end, you need a conclusion. So this is the basic structure. For the intro, you might be thinking of two or three lines. Then for the argument or main body, there you are, and then for the conclusion. And within those, just add in some key points or something in a very small and a brief one, so that you just, when you just see that sentence, see those words, then you are able to recall that what sentence you wanted to say. So just if you go with that also, you would be able to at least create 4 to 5 sentences in that way, and just build around those sentences, build around those ideas. So I was given a topic of CSR activities. So similarly, I had explained what CSR activities are and how things are and how my personal experience has helped, like what have I identified. Then I told about some of the personal experiences of what some of the CSR activities which I have seen happening in the corporate world, be it in my own organization or be it or other organizations which I have come to know about. So now moving towards the main segment of the interview. So what sort of experience I had. So here at IIM Rohtak, it started with an introduction. So I gave my introduction based upon the ideas that I already had in my mind on what all topics do I need to point while I'm introducing myself. And after that was the segment wherein they had gone through my profile and they had asked some of the questions related to mathematics and then physics. The physics was more from 11th and 12th. So I had I was given more about inertia, then gravity, then yeah, in those areas like relativity, relative speed concept. So based upon that part, I was asked some of the questions. I was appreciated for the answer that I have given. And I was even asked about rotational motion, the forces that are applied while the wheel moves in a direction. So where does the friction apply and in which direction does the force apply in the direction, and I don't remember properly, maybe the rotational energy as well, so direction and all of that. And those questions were asked for me. And following that, I was also asked some of the questions about relative speed, relative motion, comparing stone with feather, and like not just the simple one but an extended version of that, some questions on that, and then some other physics parts. Because since I come from an engineering background and I prepared for my JE mains in advance, and since I cleared my JE mains in advance, so these questions were a bit easier for me to tackle at that moment. And then post this session was done with all these questions, Then we move next to the current affairs segment, wherein I was asked questions about the what are the current affairs, name this government body, name the person who is heading this specific department and so on. Which these are the general things that you keep preparing, like the Prime Minister, President, the Defence Minister, the Finance Minister, and so on. The list goes on. So just be prepared with all of these questions. Just have them jotted down or just memorize them, because you never know when people can ask you. I have been asked these questions so many number of times in the interviews. So this is first shot, you need to prepare it. So just be prepared with that. Along with this, don't forget to know about the parliament, upper house, lower house, what are the different segments that are there in the parliament. Then, like here in this one, personally I was asked about number of seats that are present in the upper parliament, in the lower parliament, who the speaker of both of these parliaments. Then, and something more related to this I was asked, which I don't remember properly, but yeah, so this was the major flow of questions which were asked to me. So be prepared with this. Make sure to revise your civics. I've heard some of the people also got questions based on geography, so be prepared with civics, geography. Then you have your physics, which was asked to me. If you come from an engineering background, then be prepared. On a safer side, be prepared. If you don't remember the concepts clearly, then be prepared with your physics and to some extent maths as well, and the current affairs and the names of all the important people that are there in the government. Just make sure you know them properly, because these are some of the points where you can easily gain marks, and if you go wrong here, then it gives a very bad impression. So just be prepared with this. And there were some questions related to why I want to do my MBA, then what would I see, where do I see myself in the future, and some basic questions which we generally get. So be prepared with this. So this was how the overall was, and how would I rate the vibe of the interview. It was pretty good. It was very good. The vibe was very pleasant, motivating as well, and I like the vibe. Like even in cases where you do mistake or you're not sure, the faculty or the panelists were positive enough and were encouraging enough so that you can try on. And always, as I always tell this thing, whenever you're not sure, even just try to put forward your thought process, because thought process is what they are looking for. It definitely, the final answer is definitely one thing, but the thought process is also a big major chunk where you can gain marks. So don't forget to just share your logical thinking, that you're thinking, or the way you think you would be able to reach the solution for the answer. So with this, we come to the end of my interview experience at IIM Rohtak. I think the interview went for around 15 to 20 minutes. That's what I could say. And along with this, guys, there's one thing. Again, the interview is online for you, like it was for us. Then make sure that you have all your documents ready. Just wherever you're sitting, just keep all the documents ready, be it your CAT score or be it your Aadhaar card or any of the PAN card or anything. Just be prepared that you have all these documents, because we never know when a professor can ask you to show this for as a verification. So be prepared for this. So I used to keep all of them handy. So with this, I come to the end of this video. I really hope that you found this video helpful. I hope you get into the dream college of yours, and wish you all the very, very, very best, and wish you all the very best for your interview at IIM Rohtak. I hope to see you there at IIM Rohtak, and to see you as my junior. Would love to meet you then. Please mention that you have watched this video, and that would just make my day. So don't forget to check out all the other videos which I would be posting on the playlist of my interview experience playlist. I will be adding the link somewhere in the description as well as in the I button. So please make sure that you check that out as well. And thank you for watching my video. And if you found this video helpful, then please don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video and share it with all your friends so that it might help them as well. Bye bye.